The following is based on a true story. All alterations have been made to make me look much, much cooler. To fully understand this video, you will need a basic knowledge of linear algebra, but most of the video can still be enjoyed even without this knowledge. Alright, I fought through hundreds of monsters and dodged dozens of traps, but I'm almost there. Soon, the sword that makes the shing noise will be mine. Just gotta get through these puzzle doors. Let's see, bunch of lights, along with a pattern. I guess I need to make the lights look like the pattern? If I click on one... Oh, I see. So when I click on a light, it flips between being on and off, and so do all the lights that are adjacent to it, up, down, left, right, and diagonal. Now I've just got to figure out how to manipulate this. Like this. Oh, and then... There we go. There! That was nothing. I'm sure the rest of these doors will be easier than taking candy from a... Okay. Take a deep breath. You're not going to give up that easily, are you? That sword that goes shing isn't going to acquire itself. There's got to be a way to figure this out. You're a math major, right? Maybe if I take this puzzle and throw math at it, it will break open and reveal its secrets. Let's just see what I have in here. Get that. I have this and... Oh yeah, of course, that. Alright, let's give this a shot. First, let's look at what my goal is. I start out with the first combination of lights, and my goal is to make it look like the second combination of lights. To do this, I need to click on lights to turn them from off to on or from on to off. Well, it will be helpful if I can refer to each light without having to describe where it is each time I want to talk about it. If I can make this more abstract, I can remove the parts that are distracting me and just focus on the parts that matter. Why don't we give each of the lights a label? I could use letters, but there are 20 slots, so that's a lot to keep track of. I'll use numbers instead. Okay, there we go. Now I can say that I'm looking at light number 9 and know exactly where I'm pointing. What else? Well, if I want to talk about what I'm trying to get to, I need to say whether each of these positions is on or off. So this is what I'm trying to accomplish. Seems a little complicated. I could abbreviate the... Nah, both on and off start with the same letter, so that would just be confusing. Let's go with lit and unlit. I can put an L in one of the positions to say that the light is lit, and a U in a position to say that it's unlit. I can name things whatever I want, so who's gonna stop me? Wait, is that... Are you... laughing at me? Oh, just you wait, game. Just you wait. We'll see who's laughing by the time I'm done with you. No, I'm not crazy. You're crazy. Ugh, so many letters. This is getting a little overwhelming. Maybe I should try something easier first? That'll be nicer to solve, and then maybe I can apply it to the problem that I actually want to figure out. Ah, this is much better. I already solved this problem by hand, but it'll be easier to see the structure with only 9 positions to worry about. Alright, there we go. 9 positions, each either lit or unlit. Here's where the puzzle starts us off, and here's where we want to end up. Now what? Well, I know how to go from one to the other if I'm allowed to do whatever I want. Just gotta flip these lights and leave these other ones alone. Let's try labeling these as well. Maybe a check mark if I need to flip the light and an X if I don't. Cool. So, this is what I want to accomplish. Now what? Actually, I don't know. I've labeled things to make the problem easier to talk about, and I've shown what I need to accomplish, but it's not like I can just flip each light individually. The puzzle makes it so that each time I flip a light, the ones around it flip as well. Now I'm just back to square one on this. Let me think. Ugh, maybe this is the wrong way of thinking about the problem. I guess I could go back and try a different way that focuses more on each step by itself. Wait a second. Each step by itself. This picture of lights I want to flip and lights I don't want to flip isn't something I can do just because I want to. I have to do the steps that the game gives me. But I can draw a picture of each of those steps in the same way. If I click on this upper left light, this shows how the lights change, either flipping or staying the same. In fact, I can do this for every single one of the nine possible moves, like this. Okay, got it. Now I just need to figure out the combination of these that will get me the more complicated version that I'm aiming for. But how do I connect them? I can't really see an obvious way to go from these to the last one. Well, let's just mess around with this for a second and see if anything happens. Might as well try something to gain more info, right? I could click on more than one light. What happens then? Here's the original. Let's try clicking the top left corner, and then after that, clicking the top middle light. Okay, now what happened? Well, I noticed that down here we had three lights that didn't change at all, whether we did the first step or the second step. So those are still the same, they weren't affected by anything. And that makes sense, since neither the first step nor the second step by themselves would have changed those lights. Then there are these four lights. The first step changed them all, and the second step also changed them. In the end, after we do both steps, those four lights haven't really changed, or rather, they've changed back to what they originally were before we started. And lastly, we have these two lights. Just the second step changed them. So it seems that if only one of the steps has an effect, then those lights will remain flipped. We don't have sort of the cancellation going on that we had with these four lights over here. So, this change added to this change gives you this change. It's sort of like combining the two moves gives you a new move. But all of these marks are starting to get in the way, especially since this is starting to remind me of addition. Maybe we should change these to numbers. Okay. I'll use a 1 for the spots that flip, and a 2 for the spots that don't flip. Then, if I add these together. This doesn't look quite right. Earlier, I said that the spots that are unflipped by both steps should still be unflipped, but those spots have changed from 2s into 4s when I add these together. I need a number that doesn't change when you add it to itself. Oh! Zero should do the trick. Let's try this again with 1 for flipping and 0 for unflipping. Oh, hey, when I do that, it's like the numbers represent how many times I flip a spot. The ones show that I'm flipping the spot once, and the zeros show that I'm flipping those spots no times. We may be onto something here. Well, that's a little better. The unflipped spots are still unflipped, and the spots that were flipped once are still flipped once. But these twos are making this difficult. It's true that those spots get flipped twice, but I said earlier that that's the same as not being flipped at all. So those twos should be the same as the zeros. Oh, that's it. If I mod by two, then the twos will be zeros. And now this shows what changes when I do both steps. Side note, for those not familiar with the concept, modding by two basically just means that we divide a number by two and check the remainder. So, for instance, 3 mod 2 is 1, and 2 mod 2 is 0. It's basically a way of saying whether a number is even or odd, which works here because an odd number of flips will leave a light changed, but an even number of flips will put the light back where it was originally. This is starting to remind me of something. I'm basically taking these squares of numbers and adding them together by adding the numbers in each corresponding position. Oh, wait, that's it. This is reminding me of linear algebra. Each of these possible steps has 9 positions, each of which has a 0 or a 1 in it. Note, don't worry too much if you haven't studied linear algebra yet. You can still understand the basic thread of what we'll be doing. What's important isn't the specific math concepts, it's understanding the methods of problem solving. Okay, I'm going to need to rearrange this to make it match the tools I learned from my linear algebra class. Let's just take this and stretch it out into a single long vector. There we go. Now the spots go from 1 to 9 vertically. So here are the 9 possible steps I'm allowed to take, and here's the step that I'm trying to get to happen. Now, if I go back to the example I was just doing, then to show the effect of doing these two steps, I need to add these vectors together. And there we go. All right, now what? I could just start adding some of these vectors together and hope that I end up getting the vector on the right, but that would essentially be the same as just guessing. That's basically what I was doing at the start. What I need to figure out is the correct choice of vectors to add together to get the vector on the right. That rings a bell, though. Oh, yeah! That's what a linear combination is. And if I remember my theorems correctly, then I can use an augmented matrix to solve that problem. So, here's my augmented matrix, and if I use Gauss-Jordan elimination, that will tell me which vectors to pick to get what I'm looking for. Kind of annoying it's a 9x9 matrix, since that makes it a lot of work, but at least most of the spots are zero. I just have to remember that all of this is modded by 2, so adding 2 ones will always result in a 0. And doing 0 minus 1 will also result in a 1. So, this says that I need to take one of each of these vectors and 0 of each of these vectors. So if I take all the vectors that I indicated and put them together, yes, that was what I was trying to achieve. I wonder if this will solve the problem. Hey, there we go. That was even easier than figuring it out the normal way. Well, I guess it took a lot longer at the beginning, but once I figured out the math, it was a lot easier. Okay, now I've solved the smaller problem. Let's get back to the bigger one. This one has 20 positions, which means if I do the same thing, I need vectors of length 20. Ugh. Note to viewers at home, Don't do this by hand. Computers are much better and faster. Okay. I finally did it. I found the positions that I need to click. Yes. Yes. Finally.
Yes!
I threw math at it and it worked. I always knew spending 5 years on that degree would help me solve the most important problems in my life. And now, to claim my just rewards. Worth it.